Sure. Thanks for everybody for coming out. It's good to see everyone again. Certainly speaking for our whole program, we're excited to get the 2010 season kicked off and underway. I've been really happy with the progress our football team has made since the end of spring. We got through spring and had to take some steps in a lot of those areas. I've seen a lot of growth from our football team. So I certainly feel like we're much more ready to play this game than we would have been a month ago. And our players did a lot of hard work in the offseason. And now we get a chance to test ourselves against a very good football team. We're playing the four-time defending Sun Belt champions, a team that won 9 games a year ago. Their only other losses last year in the regular season were to Arkansas and Florida. And they have a lot of skill back. And certainly playing down at Troy at their place will have its own challenges. So, again, we're excited to get going. And any questions you have?
Coach, why is Matt the guy that you're going with on the first game?
I mean, he's our best quarterback. So he had a lead. Certainly coming out of the spring, I thought he was ahead of the other guys at the position. And from the start of camp, he's done nothing except extend that lead. So, I thought that would be a tightly contested position to be our starting quarterback. And the truth of it is it has not been a difficult decision. The more difficult decision is who's number two. But he is clearly the number one quarterback right now, and we have a lot of confidence in him going into this game.
Aaron's listed right now number two. Is that based on his experience playing last year, or is that based on?
Yeah, he has the most working knowledge of the offense, but Kellen Pagel, and we had a freshman, Trent Hurley, come in who was very impressive. And all three of those guys were not one has really pulled themselves away from the pack. So like I said, Matt pulled himself away from everybody else, but the 2, 3, and 4 are all right in it. And if we had to play them, I don't know if one guy would be capable of going the distance. At that point, we'd probably have to play a couple of them. You'd like things to clean up, and in some cases they do. The race for our starting quarterback to be cleaned up very quickly. For the backup, that hasn't cleaned up, and as these guys go through practice every day, they're still competing for it.
From the end of your August drills, what was the biggest surprise? What was the biggest concern now that they've come to a close?
Well, I think the concern is always, when you're a younger team, is just eliminating missed assignments, missed alignments. You don't want to beat yourself. If you don't play well because you lost a one-on-one matchup or the other guy was better than you, so be it. But and that's still as we go into this game. We don't want the ball to go over our head because we didn't get a coverage check. We don't want to take a sack because we weren't on the same page protection-wise. And that's a concern every year. But the younger you are and the more new starters you have, it's just important that everybody gets on the same page. And again, that's where I feel that we've made the most improvements since the spring, that the one thing we chart every practice, every scrimmage is the amount of, what we call not beating yourself, mental errors, missed assignments on both sides of the ball. And that number for us has steadily dropped from spring through camp. And we had what I call a lot of good 3-yard plays. Our offensive staff and our offensive players want to make a touchdown every play. Our defensive players and our defensive staff want a sack or an interception every play. What I love is a good 3 to 4 yard play. That everybody did their job, they did their correct assignment, and you run the ball, and the free hitter made a play at 3 yards and didn't miss an open field tackle. And that type of football was played a lot more in this camp than happened in the spring.
Starting on the road with a young team, is there any message that you're trying to get through to them as far as dealing with the pressures that come with
it? I mean, we have a lot of guys that have played, they just didn't start. Yeah. We were at Missouri last year. We certainly, the experience of the bowl game, Troy's a tough place to play. They've won 23 home openers in a row. Their head coach is 19-0 in home openers. Their record over the past 5 years at home is, I think, 23-5. There's a reason they're good, and good football programs play well at home. And that's what makes this such a great challenge. And it makes it exciting too, that we're playing a very good football team that plays very well at home. But we've played other good teams on the road, and you know, we'll play other good teams this year on the road. So it's our first challenge of many.
Do you take anything from last year? Obviously, both teams are relatively new, but just being able to beat them pretty handily last year?
Yeah, I mean, the whole thing about, our players played against them, so they're not a complete unknown. It's not like, you're playing a team you haven't played before. Like Tulsa, you know, very few of our guys played in that bowl game 3 years ago, so that'll be a team we don't know a lot about. So there's a little bit of a familiarity, but you know, to me, every season is a new season. I'm not a big believer in there's carryover, or you know, you're upset that this team beat you by so many points 2 years ago. And this is, to me, that type of motivation wears off quickly. This is a new football team. There's a different chemistry. There's different leadership, and they've got to forge their own path. And that path obviously starts this Saturday. So, you know, certainly we look at last year's game because, you know, they have the same head coach and we have the same staff, and you know, their defensive coordinator is the same. They have a different offensive coordinator, but Coach Edenfield was promoted from within. So, you know, they'll have a new quarterback. You know, I'm sure there'll be some changes in their offensive scheme, but generally when you promote from within, you're not looking to make wholesale changes. And so we look at that because we're going to see similar players and similar schemes, as will they. So, but we don't get caught up in the result. You know, there's some things that we did last year in that game well, and obviously we're going to try to repeat. And I'm sure they're looking at the film, and they probably feel they had some missed opportunities that if they had taken advantage of, maybe the result would have been different.
Coach, you mentioned some of the improvements the team's made throughout the summer. Is there a specific position where you've really seen some of the players adapt and improve going into this week?
Well, our kicking game, I think, is expected to be really a lot better. Last year we really struggled on kickoffs and we didn't kick the ball deep, and the placements of it weren't always where we wanted, and certainly getting Brian Wright from Michigan I think is going to help us a lot there. I'm very excited about our front seven and defense. You know, even though, again, a lot of them haven't started, that's where our most experience comes back. Angelo Magnone, Chris Jones, Kevin Alvarado are all returning starters. I really like the way our linebacker tandem, Champ Woods and Dwayne Woods, have played in camp. They've been very active, very athletic, and I think that is a group that really has a chance, if they continue to gel, to be a real force for us and a real strength of our football team. And the other group I'm really excited about is our wide receivers. Everybody talks about losing Freddie Barnes. Again, do we have Freddie? Are we going to have a guy that catches 155 balls? Probably not. But I think the overall strength and depth of that group is much better than it was a year ago. And, they've got to perform in games. And Freddie obviously made a lot of plays for us last year. But, we're certainly more comfortable with the ball being distributed all over the field than we felt. You know, we didn't feel that way last year. Obviously, with what we did, I think we broke down last year and Freddie had 155 catches, but I think we threw him the ball over 220 times. So you just break that down over the course of a season, about one every three plays we were trying to get him the football. And that's not the case this year. I mean, we feel much better wherever the ball goes. You know, we feel good about five or six receivers we have. We feel we have better depth at tight end. And certainly having Willie back has helped us a lot too.